All right, so I got the Myrtle Beach Bedazzled South Carolina shirt, and I got this 2011 Von Franco shirt that I'm gonna be suntanning out here. I got some bricks. I'm gonna put them under the shirt, well, inside the shirt, and I'm gonna leave them out here all summer. What's up, y'all? I'm back with an update on these shirts I wanted to fade. So the front looks absolutely thrashed, looks super good. The top faded more because of the wind blowing it, and I would leave it without fixing it for multiple days. That's the first one. And then here's the second one. Look at the difference. Holy crap. That's crazy. I can't wait to wash it. See if any of the fuzziness will rub off. So I'm gonna go ahead and flip these. And at the end of August, I'm gonna wash them. So these have been out for about a month on the front. I'm gonna flip them both. And yeah. All right, so this is what the back is now looking like after another month. So I'm gonna take them, I'm gonna wash them, and I'm gonna show y'all what they look like on.
All right, so this is how the first shirt came out. I really like the way it looks. It kind of looks like a sun fade tie-dye. Super natural, super cool. I will say it came out like this because the wind would blow it at times, and a lot of times I would just leave it for multiple days without fixing it. So that's why it kind of has this tie-dye effect, but I think this one is really cool, and I'm actually going to be giving this away because it don't really fit me too well. The tag on this says extra large, but I guess I'm an XL, a double XL now, so I'm gonna definitely be giving this away. Comment below if you want to win this t-shirt. It's not vintage, but it is cool, I think, in my opinion. Let's try on the other one. So this is the other one. I will be keeping this one. It fits me a lot better, a lot boxier, bigger, but it also has that tie-dye look to it again because the wind would blow it and I wouldn't fix it for multiple days. But I really like how this came out. I think it's definitely unique, and something fun to do with, you know, shirts here you don't care too much about. Originally I wanted to do my 1996 Harley t-shirt, vintage single stitch all around, but I wanted to try it on ones that I didn't care too much about first, just to see how it would come out. But I think it came out really well. Would I do this to my 1996 Harley? Probably not, but I like it. It's definitely different, and I'm gonna be keeping this one. But if you wanna win this other one, just make sure you comment below and leave a like and subscribe, and I will definitely be picking a random comment to win this. All right, let's get into the rest of the video. I'm at the good old Goodwill, and I found one thing, just this Adidas jacket. Nice little patch, cool little Adidas pull, little half zip, vintage. Found this nice Louisville Cardinals, on the best Fruit of the Loom tag. Single stitch all around, XXL. I'm pick this up for $2. Found this super modern Target exclusive Pokemon shirt, but I think I'm gonna get it because I love Pokemon and it's pretty cool. So yeah, found this Tennessee Titans cut tag, probably Y2K. Looks kind of older. Football season's right around the corner, so I picked this up for $2. I ain't been to Peddler's Mall in a minute. Thought I'd stop by.
Let's see, what's this? A bull shirt. $10. No, thank you. That's cool. Manchester United soccer kit. Oh shit, I got the shorts too. $7. That definitely seems worth it. I think I'm gonna pick that up. No price tag on the jersey. Yeah, I'm gonna get this. $7. Definitely seems worth it. Oh shoot.
Not the fake Gucci's.
See what they got over here. Cool hat. $7. They're taxing. Not seeing anything. Old dolls. No, they don't work. Old records. I'm gonna go through these, see if I can find anything. Alright, so I didn't find any records looking through all those, but after looking at this, it's supposed to be an Adidas symbol right here. So I think this is fake. And on the tag, no Adidas. And on the shorts, no Adidas tags. So this would have been worth it, but it's fake, so I'm not gonna pick it up. Found this nice Oilers hat, but they want $48 for it. It is vintage, made in USA. Too much though.
I got the motherfucking year he. Yo, this is cool. I think this is an Avon bottle, yeah. It's an Avon bottle, but this is cool.
I've been looking for one of these vintage military jacket liners, and this one actually fits me. I think I'm gonna get this, and it's only $12. Online, these run from like 30 to 50, so pretty nice deal. So I didn't really find too much there. Just this personal vintage army jacket, which is pretty cool. I might sell it. I don't know.
I'm at this one consignment place. They got like tag deals.
So on that last clip, my phone died, so I couldn't record anything in there. But I did pick up these Nike VaporMax Pluses for $13. But I'm pretty sure these go for at least 70 to 100. So it's a pretty good pickup. I might keep them. They're 11 and a half. So I wear 12, so I might be able to squeeze in them. These are really nice. But yeah. Some nice little Nike shoes from the original owner. I got these through my job. He was gonna be giving these away, donating them. And he knows me and knows I like clothes and like older stuff. So he was like, if there's anything you want, you can keep it. 60s Stanford cardigan. I only see one listed online. This was his, and it's from the 60s, so that's really cool. Got this nice little This is awesome. I wish it was bigger, man. If it was bigger, I'd definitely keep this for next summer. This is one of those, like, net workout shirts. The tag on it is Athletic Works. It's a size medium. But I want to get one of these eventually. Then we got a nice little thing, Made in USA vintage sweater vest. Appreciate it if you watch this part of the video. Make sure you leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and stay tuned for the next one. Appreciate it. Peace.